So previously on This Is Not the Autobahn, the first episode started with like this whole like 80s looking infomercial, and these two people were talking about a potato looking rock thing, and that got done, and then it said this is episode one, and then the credit sequence went to the actual movie, and you meet these two people, and they're called Griff Bitter and Zoe Bishop, yeah, and then they're talking about how they're going to potato rock, so it all comes around at the end, and then it says This Is Not the Autobahn, which is the name of the movie, and then there's a shot of the car going that way, but she's sitting that way, so it's like totally against the 180 rule. And then she's like, oh, look, a sock monkey. And there's a sock monkey, and they look at it, and they freak out, and they swerve to avoid it, and they crash. And that was episode one.
Where the hell are we?
I don't know the name of this town.
Our car is completely ruined.
Oh, I know. We need to find a mechanic.
Wait.
There's flames coming out of this.
That, I think, is a mechanic.
Right. Let's go.
All right.
Excuse me, sir. Excuse me. We were wondering if you could help us out.
Yeah. Well, see, what happened is our car crashed, and it's on the side of a ditch, and we really need to get potato rocks. So if you could help us out at all, that would be fantastic.
That'd be great. How so?
You know, just go to the car, you know. Use your mechanic skill thing to do.
Basically, anything to do a little tweaking, just to save it. Basically,
the tire's on fire.
You know, we saw the sign, you're a mechanic.
So long as you can help me out here.
Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah, anything.
Sure.
If you would be so kind as to point to the red wire under the hood.
Okay.
Not the blue, but the red. Or the yellow one. I'd rather not be directed to that one either. No, it is the red one that I'm looking for.
Uh-huh.
Green, purple, mahogany. Those would be incorrect. Yes, I am searching for the one true red-hued wire in this cluster.
And this would be it.
And let it be known that I seek not the pink nor brown. Yea, verily, I am looking for the one true red individual in this veritable rainbow twixt motor and hood. I'm colorblind.
Oh.
Duh. Well, that would explain the whole lot.
Yeah.
The red wire thing.
Yeah, right.
Wait a minute. So wouldn't the whole colorblind thing maybe, impede on your ability to be a mechanic?
I have experienced the odd electrocution here and there, yes.
Yikes. Well, anyway, maybe you could go come look at our car now and try not to get electrocuted because we're already, late on time and everything.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry. I deal only with bolts.
Yoo-hoo! Yoni!
Quick, act like you're asleep.
I didn't know Yoni had some nice young customers. Just look at the pair of you. Yoni! Oh, do forgive him. He always takes his power naps this time of day. He's colorblind, so he gets his numbers mixed up. I sure hope he didn't quote a ridiculous price for you again. Whatever he said, happens.
Well, actually, we were having some trouble getting him.
Would one of you like to come and get some food? You big city folk are always hungry, right? That's why you're so fat.
Yeah,
Excuse me?
That would be great.
I was speaking to the delicate-minded young girl.
Oh. Well, okay. You can just go with her, and I'll just wake up this guy and
Griff.
Fix our car.
Yes, sweet impressionable young fool.
Excuse me?
We've got Mike and Ike.
Oh, Mike and Ike. I love those, don't you? Will you go with her? And I'll just, stay here. It'll be okay. It'll be fine.
Griff, I don't think we should be splitting up right now. This is like how motor films start. This crazy.
I'll be fine.
But Griff!
Well, okay. Just stuff some Mike and Ike's in your pockets. Come back for me later. It's not like I'll starve.
Shall we?
Whatever. Just lead the way.
You're not from around here, are you?
No, not exactly.
Do you like trees? Into the forest? Goodness, it takes a long time for you city folk to let down your stuffy disposition. But never you mind. Once I dig my claws into something,
I never let go.
So, what's a young thing like yourself called?
Zoe.
And a last name? I don't have one. Yeah. I don't have one.
Zoe.
Right, yeah.
How cute that is. You remind me of Cher.
Well, you know her?
Not personally, dear. Just enough to be reminded of her when I think of you.
Thanks. No matter. We'll get you a last name very quickly, little dandelion.
What?
Do you like nature?
Like trees and stuff? And the eternal rain of this damn place?
Well, there's so much more than trees and rain and stuff. There's so much waiting for you out there, Zoe.
Did you two say we're gonna get food?
Oh, but there's so much more sustenance available for you in the sucking of a single acorn. Imagine a walk through the forest, the branches coming in around you, embracing you.
Right. Okay. I think maybe we should just go back and eat. You know, Mike and Ike's.
Yanni? You can wake up now. Your wife left about 10 minutes ago. It's okay.
Much appreciated.
Right, yeah. So I was thinking you could look at my car now.
Your car?
Yeah.
Is not a boat.
But you said that...
You'll have to go into town for that.
Fine, okay. Could you just at least guide me into town so I could find a non-colorblind mechanic?
You truly want to know?
Yeah. Why?
It is not an easy passage. If one truly wants to journey into the heart of town, he will find it. But woe be to the person who does not follow the path.
I have a confession to make, Zoe.
Oh?
Gwendolyn Canasta's not my real name.
Oh?
It's Floral Savant, High Priestess of the Second Limb.
Hey, so about those Mike and Ikes.
Shh, my little tulip leaf.
Listen, Mrs. Savant or Floral or whatever you like to be called, I really
I
should
am
go
one
back.
With the Fildestrian High. My little piggy, I have come to invite you home.
Wait a minute, Fildestrian Hive? I know about you people, I saw a special on HBO, you guys are-
One with nature?
No, you're the one that girl from that sitcom made up, and when she was hopped up on crack, back in the 70s.
I have some literature in my car.
No thanks, Mrs. Canasta. You know, I think I'm gonna get going.
But how will you find your way back? You don't know where you are.
Look, I think we're in the forest right next to the garage. I can probably see Griff and Mr. Canasta. I can probably
I'm afraid I didn't want it to come to this.
To what?
Yes, the path. The true way will lead you directly to your intended destination.
In the wrong way?
It'll get you thereabouts.
Mr. Canasta, please, show me the way. Of the true path.
The true path does not come without a price. Here is what you must do. You must wait for the seed.
Help you see the truth that is our way of life
with him. What are you doing? Oh my!
My leader, are you hurt?
My dear Savant, for if we are one with nature and its itty bitty creatures, nature will do us no harm.
is one with nature.